Today's glorious full build on the workshop AMT's 1995 GMC Sonoma SLS. If anything says 90s, it's the little mini trucks. Check out this on the box right there. That teal color, that pink stripe, that says 90s vehicle styling for the American automaker. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. This thing is definitely a nostalgia build. We got that beautiful GMC body on there, that little pickup, what I used to call the tennis shoe design when they went from the more squared off body style like I used to have in my 85 GMC, and they went to the very rounded aero style that was getting so popular back then. Molding is still crisp. All the little clips to hold the bed onto the body are still great. Accent inside the bed looks awesome. We've even got rib detail underneath. Everything looks great. Even the side moldings are crisp and clear. This thing doesn't have a bit of chrome on it, but that is okay. We got it all set. Those moldings will make painting and detailing easier. Let's get some more trees out here. We've got those bucket seats that the little pickups were known for. Great seats. Awesome seats. We got our hood there, our tailgate. Even the tailgates had a rounded profile to them. Under the hood and inside the tailgate is great accent and detail. We've got that 90s GM dashboard made out of that soft gray squishy kind of vinyl with those big poofy steering wheels. These were not the high times of automotive detailing, yet us older farts, I turned 18 in 1995, remember them fondly. I had a buddy with a little black Chevy pickup, identical to these Sonomas, just with the Chevy brand on it. We got the nice mirrors there, the nice squared off mirrors. Those will assemble easily. We've got full steering detail. Looks like we can do posable steering on this one. We've got separate fuel tanks, springs, differential, exhaust system, intake system, front suspension. Excelente. We've got our round plastic bumpers. We've got our rear bumper pan. That's a beautiful mold right there. You just need to paint it body color and get the little top steps in a black non-skid material. There's our mirrors. I made the mistake and called the other parts the mirrors. We have a nice center console there with the cup holders. Our nice 4.3 liter Vortec V6, a 350 with two cylinders removed. Bulletproof engines lasted forever and worked very well. You could really beat on those things, which a lot of the younger guys that bought those trucks definitely tested that theory. We've got the nice frame here, beautifully detailed, straight as an arrow. Not seeing any flash aside from this stuff, but that's not on the actual frame, which gets cut off there. And this stuff, if it is on there, just snaps off real easy. Got our spare tire, radiator, excellent door panels with speakers. Sweetness. Let's get more plastic out. What is that? What is that? We'll see that in just a second. We've got the body parts for the High Rider version, the fender flares. Those will go all the way around, and we got that nice grill bumper set up there. We've got our snowboard and booties. This is new for this kit. Round 2's remolding a lot of stuff and adding cool accessories. So the booties and the snowboard are brand new in this kit. You won't see them in other editions. We've got the wheels. We've got two options. We've got our stock wheels. We've got our High Rider wheels. We've got our grill and what looks like some brake discs. I'll have to take a look, make sure that's what they are when we get building. So those are all set right there. Excellent options. And in the wee corner, don't miss it, that nice separate GMC logo, which means you can get your orangish paint on that and attach that separately. You don't have to pick it out from the grill. Now let's take a look at the other thing that's in the box before I start building everything. We've got some decals. We've got transparent red parts for the tail light and the third brake light. We've got our headlight surrounds. Remember, these things got cloudy if you parked it outside. And we've got our glass, leaving it in there so it doesn't get scratched up. We've got the awesome decal set for the snowboard. That pink striping on the side is done for you. Even the molding all the way around the sides, which would be hard to paint, really hard to paint, is all done for you in decals that fit. We've got full gauges, GMC logos, we've got multiples, SLS logos, and we've got two nice Colorado license plates and a window sticker all in that decal sheet. And to wrap things up, we've got four, what I see as no-name, treaded tires. If you wanted to do the High Rider, you'll just have to get some off-road tires, which are available through round two, and you'll have a nice build. Now I'm going to get the gluing things together and we'll be back. If you build at the speed of fun and enjoy yourself, you can get to all this within a couple hours. It's not hard to do at all. There are no fit issues with the kit so far. I've tested the body on the frame. I've tested the box on the frame. I've put the engine in and made sure that everything lines up. And so far, everything lines up perfectly. We'll start off showing you that by showing you how nice that rear bumper goes on. Just presses in with three pins. Love when they give pins for placement. And then the box, the tailgate can go on. Now, if you want to leave the tailgate operational, it does have pins on either end that you can leave to fold it down, but I cut those off, smoothed it out, and glued it on completely closed. I don't have any reason to want to open that in my model building, so we're going to leave that as is. That's ready for paint. The cab is also ready for paint. The only work we had to do on that was insert the firewall and the radiator. I will go in and just touch up the radiator with some black before we're all done here when I do the top of the radiator shroud as well. But that is all molded in one piece, so I put the radiator on there anyways. Since I'd have the brush out no matter what, we will get to paint that cab. The firewall lines up nicely. Everything presses in and it joins up with the top of the cowl there beautifully without any issues at all. We've got a lot of underhood detail that's a separate part, which will make painting much more easy for us. I did glue the wheel backs all together just because of the fact that, once again, I don't play with my models and I don't want them to roll off my shelves, so I go ahead and glue that in. Don't have any problems with that. That's ready for paint. We've got the seats done. Their backs go on. They fit on nicely. No issues. Run glue in there and we're all set to go. We've got the dashboard, the steering wheel, and the steering column ready for paint on this little section of sprue. You can see where the sprue will detach. It won't matter anyways where some paint is left on. That, I did glue that together with model glue because I like the stronger hold of a plastic welded bond when I do those parts. I did leave the shocks, intake system, and exhaust separately on the tree. I did not attach those to the frame or to the engine. I want to paint those separately off to the side of their own color and then attach them with super glue later when I do my weathering. Same with the exhaust. I did not attach the exhaust. I left the crossover pipe, the Y pipe, and the main exhaust system as it is. I want to do some special things with that. We got all of our under the hood components. We've got different bottles and reservoirs. We've got the back of our alternator. We've got some pumps or some tanks here. We've got our master cylinder. Those can all get primed on this tree. Then we will take them off and paint them individually and can glue those under the hood. Our spare tire is going to be done separately. Our drive shaft will be done separately. Our belt and pulley system is all set to go. That would all be black on a GM anyways of the 90s, except for the alternator, which will be showed, which we will attach later. But everything else is going to be all painted black because they weren't making them exciting. We got our interior door panels, which is lovely. We can paint them on here. And where the sprue's attached, there won't be any issues when we cut that off. You'll never see that part of the interior anyways. Our front bumper, I cannot attach to the body at this point, so it is separate. So I separated it. We'll be able to get that painted and glued on. Once we get the grill in place up here, the bumper will glue on the bottom of it. So we won't have a problem with that. The 4.3 in this kit is a beautiful engine. Goes together easily. It actually joins top to bottom. Has a separate starter with a pin and a solenoid on it. It's got our oil filter, pan, transmission, and those nice designs of the 4.3. A very durable engine. I always liked it. So that is all set. We don't have the intake on. This is all black in the real world with a raw metal transmission. So that's how we will be painting it up in this kit as well. So you can see that is lovely and no issues. We've got our bed there. Don't forget your snow boots and snowboard if you want to go that way. Our hood's ready to go. Then when we get done painting, we can just slice it off right there. Take a little bit of the body color on a small brush and touch up the back area of the hood where you're not really going to see it anyways, and you're good to go. The frame is all set, and I did join a lot of the stuff on there except for the shocks. We got it all ready to go. The tank's on there. This is going to be a build more in my area, what I'm used to seeing. So painting the tank a separate color won't matter because when you pick these up, they squirted them with that rubber undercoating anyways. So we can do the whole thing in black. They weren't even trying to not make a mess when they hosed those frames down at Z-Bart. They just squirted down the whole thing, but we got our leafs on the back. I measured the axle to make sure it's front and back, even though it has pins. We do have the right length front and back. The mounting holes for the cab are very prominent, and our box will line in on the grooves back here. So we know that everything lines up. I've test fitted it, and you can see the front suspension looks lovely. I did make a comment in the parts review that I thought it would have steerable, posable steering, and it doesn't. These are actually keyed in a half moon shape. To open this up and steer these actual axles would be super easy. Just drill it out or use your knife to hollow it out so it's a round shape instead, and you'd be able to pose those wherever you wanted. I want them on straight so they're absolutely fine the way they are. I'm gonna get all this stuff into paint. Don't forget, if you wanna do the high rider, all your parts are there, including fancy schmancy guarded taillights, brush guard on the front end with that fancy bumper. Your high rider parts are all right there, and the wheels are in the kit. You can go ahead and glue those onto the body and the box before this, but I'm doing a regular two-wheel drive GMC Sonoma SLS. So I'm going to get things into paint. Come along with me. Thank you. Moving along after paint, we start putting the small details on everything. Check out that decal work. That says 90s all over it with the squiggly. Now they use that on a cup design, made it super famous. But yeah, we've got our decals on everything. We're just doing a little small detail work. We got our bumper steps on. We got our door handles and our trim done. And I just pressed the box together so I could get the decals on without any issues. We got our little black out there. For our radiator, like I said, I would hand paint. I'm going to leave the rest body color under there. I have the grill all ready to go. If you kind of hold that back and ignore the GMC logo, it looks like an F-150 grill from the late 90s. That's what that looks like to get those headlights to stay clear and silver. When I did all the painting, you just take silly putty, you pull off a section, you squish it into the areas you want to mask, and you go ahead and paint. And that simple, cheap, silly putty makes an excellent mask that won't fall out and will conform to any shape. Then we can install those pieces of headlight glass over the top and we will have a proper looking grill. We'll be able to put our GMC logo over the top and we will be all set on that. We got the bumper painted and it's lights with silver Molotow on the background. Yes, the bumper is a completely different color. He had a little issue and he accidentally tapped someone in the back end and just grabbed a plastic bumper cover from the junkyard. We got our center console ready to go using that Tamiya panel line wash. Looks awesome. Check out that awesome-tastic dashboard. Nothing says General Motors than that. In the 90s, all plain. I used a little bit of a green metallic pen to go in and do that green gauge on the radios like they always had back then so that we can see that a lot better, and then just use that panel line wash like I showed to do all the gauges and all the knobs and buttons. Touched a few of them with a black Sharpie, get them to stand out, and we have an excellent looking dashboard and instrument cluster for that. Use the decal provided, and then the glass over the top of that gives us an excellent accent. We're working on the 4.3 liter V6. We got our rusty manifolds on, we got our intake on with a little bit of black wash in there to bring out some detail. Painted off the transmission and any kind of silver or raw metal paint you want to use. We've got our belt and pulley system on there, fan clutch, and the other manifold on the other side. That looks awesome. Going to be able to go underneath there. We got the wheels done. I painted them over the chrome. Then I painted them a gunmetal to get that center look and the spokes in there. Then I took literally just a silver Sharpie and rubbed it around the wheels, painted the wheels so that they have that aluminum look to them. With the darker outer and the darker gunmetal center cap, it's got some GMC logos that are going to go in there, but otherwise the wheels are set to go. We've got our interior door panels done with all panel line washes, did black in some areas, did a dark gray in others to accentuate them, but otherwise those are the plain Jane General Motors door panels and trucks back then. We got our little bit of a lighter color flat coated interior that needs work. We got our spare tire. I'm not going to mount that in the frame. I'm actually going to mount that in the bed probably. We've got all kinds of accents. I got the boots painted and used a Sharpie to get some highlights on the boots like that. Those are going to look great. The board just needs its decals. That's all that needs to be accentuated. We got a little bit of black wash on our steering wheel to make it look nice in there. So we're putzing along. We're doing a lot of work. We got our mirrors pressed in. Those look awesome. I will be detaching these two parts in a moment so I can get the glass into the cab, get that drying before we start putting things together. I'm going to mount the engine in the frame. Get the frame a little weathered up, get the interior buttoned up together, and then we will be back for another look. The majority of the build itself is done. We just have to push things together, so we'll take another look. And then I want to get everything together and then do some light weathering. We'll take a look at that as well. We've got that interior done. The dash, don't let it throw you off. It looks lopsided because they built the dashboards to kind of aim towards the driver only. So I kept looking at it like it's crooked, but it's actually in the side holes like it should be. And that interior looks amazing. I love it. Definitely says mid-90s General Motors small pickup truck. The cab looks nice. I've got all the decals on it. We've got the glass in it now, the mirrors on it. We've got the fenders inside painted, and we're all set to go with that, so the glass goes in nicely, and I secure that in place with my normal Mod Podge just painted on like you would with glue. We've got our headlights done. Those just have to be attached to the front end. We've got our grill in place. It just needs its GMC decal. And that does stick out a ways. If you wanted to, you could shave that down quite a bit and glue it on the front. We've got our headlights ready to go. I just have to push the bezels on and get them on there. We've got our chassis all done. Our frame with our little bit of rust on the exhaust, our surface rust. We're going to be weathering up a lot of this underneath here, so we'll clean that up at that time. But you can see everything lines up nicely. That Y pipe and everything all goes together beautifully, and you don't have any issues, and that engine looks awesome underneath there, that 4.3. We got our wheels and tires all pushed together. They look great as a package. We've got the lights done on our front bumper. I'm going to start getting the body and the bed all together, get those pressed on to the frame, get that all, once we get that all assembled, get our reservoir tanks under the hood, get everything ready to go, and then we'll come back for a little bit of weathering fun. The completed kit, if you were building it right out of the box, of course, and wanted it to look factory fresh, is right in front of you. It is a stupendous looking model kit. Looks just like the S10 series GMC Sonomas and Chevy pickups. They look great. It's a nice look to it. The only thing I would change is the extended GMC logo on the nose. I would sand that down next time to make it a little less prominent. They don't stick out quite that far. But we've got the kit assembled. We've got it looking awesome. You can see underneath, it looks great. Under the hood, it looks stupendous. We got all the accessories they include. I just have to get my fat fingernail. There we go. Underneath there, and you can see that excellent underhood detail on there, and we'll get closer shots of that later, but now I get to dirty it up a little bit, and we're gonna have some fun. It is winter, it is a snowboard. You can see back there the decals on the snowboard and the boots are drying. So what I'll do while this is there, I put the spare tire in the box and super glued it into place. I don't want it to ever fall out again. We're gonna start giving this some little bit of beat up, ski hill junkie kinda, you know, travels around, goes to all the different ski hill looks. So as long as his little two-wheel drive pickup works, he's fine and he can get there nice and happy. We're gonna use a bunch of craft paints and we're gonna do some dry brushing. Burnt sienna is an excellent rusty color. So is milk chocolate. Brown iron oxide, obviously iron oxide is a perfect rust color. And because we're gonna do some snow effects, white and light ivory, they will all be dressed on, and I'm gonna try this again. I'm gonna see if I can have a different effect and not as heavy as with the 40 Ford sedan. So we got our palette here. We will squirt a little bit of paint. Let's move the camera down. Okay, so we're gonna take a little bit of paint and we're going to squirt it into our palette. Then we're gonna take a wide, stiff brush. We're gonna do underbody this time. And then this will just be a little bit of a primer, and we've done this numerous times before, but I want to get some rust highlights on the chassis, so we will take that and we'll dip our paintbrush in. You don't need a lot of paint on it. Wipe most of it off onto a paper towel, and I do mean most, and then we'll start giving a light brushing underneath the body, and we'll keep going around. And we'll keep working on it. We'll keep brushing it in. And the more and more we go, the more rust effects we get on it. I've got to do much more underneath here. But we'll keep going and getting more effects on there. We'll switch to a lighter color. We'll switch to a darker color. We'll get some white and a light ivory underneath the chassis as well for some impacted snow and snow and salt dust. We'll keep working on that. Then you flip the body over. You flip the whole truck over and you notice I don't have the wheels and tires on because we can weather them completely separate and not have them in the way so I can pack stuff up into the fenders. Then what we'll do is we won't do it as heavy on the body. We'll take smaller brushes. These are eyeliner and makeup brushes from the dollar store under their Wet n Wild brand, if you must know a brand name. Just go get brushes from the dollar store, you'll see them. And I'm gonna go around where areas where you would see rust on these pickups, like down near the bottom of the bed, and the cab line, especially at the bottom of the door seams where everybody's getting in and out of the truck, kicking off their boots, and where a lot of the splash and splatter is coming from on the road, the back of the bed. Now, if you use those high rider body panels, you wouldn't have any rust on there. They're plastic held on by clips and adhesive. So then you want to rust around the top where they always held water and rotted and rusted and got real nasty all along the top. But this is part of the body molding, so we'll be able to rust on top of it and right underneath it. I'm going to keep working on that. We'll come back for a look. All right, the snow effects came out way better this time on the 95 Sonoma SLS from AMT in 1/25th scale. And see, I did it on the 40 Ford. I didn't think it was all that great. Now I'm doing it on more vehicles, and I'm really liking the effect. And that's what you guys should do, and how you should learn how to do things is by practice, all right? You're not going to be perfect on your day out. I make mistakes all the time, guys, and I build almost 100 kits a year for this show, and I screw up, but now check it out. We're getting way better effects. We're learning things. We're figuring it out way better than we ever did before. I use the spray snow. I use dry brushing. We've talked about dry brushing. All this back here where it builds up on your rear step, and all the way snow always builds up real bad in the bed, but hardly any towards the tailgate because it swirls and blows around. That's all with spray snow. The effects on the side are dry brush and spray snow. Here's a tip when I did the spray snow this time. I took a piece of paper and I held it out in front of the truck like this, and then I spritzed it from quite a distance. That kept me from hosing down the top of the truck, because in real life, a truck that's driven all the time and hasn't been parked overnight when it snowed would have most of the stuff blown off the top and melted off the hood. So that's how I wanted to do it. And then I kind of used some dry brushing on the glass with the paint, and you can use the snow spray for that. And this is an excellent kit to have fun with it, because it's got the awesome snowboard and the two booties that I tossed in the snow pile in the back with the spare tire. We got the front bumper on. I glued it on just a little bit down on the driver's side, because when you get a new plastic bumper cover, it never fits right. The clips don't line up, and you're like, you know what? To heck with it. You get it slapped on there. He wants to go ski, man. He just starred in the movie Ski School in like 1990. He doesn't care about how his truck looks. He just wants to get there and be a ski bum all winter. And this is the excellent ski bum truck. The awesome decals, the paint job, those decals from AMT for the side moldings and those pink side stripes scream the 90s pickup trucks. And then that off-color front bumper cover just says, yep, a couple of times, two-wheel drive up in Vail, slid into a Lamborghini driven by a rich guy. What are you going to do about it, you know? So the kit is awesome. Everything fits beautifully. Check out those mirrors go on so nice because there's pre-drilled holes. That interior, oh, that interior is just nuts. And, of course, you can paint it up, you can do it as a brand new truck, you can weather the heck out of it like I have, and dirty it up, give it a little bit of a rust effect along the bottom, and dirt effect, and dirty snow. I just love how this one looks, and I'm having a lot of fun with it. So, there will be pictures after this, so you can check out under the hood. I used some dust effects under the hood, and that was it. And we will be back with another review soon. Always build for you. Thanks to our sponsor, Model Roundup, for sending this kit to be built, and we will see you at the next review.